This video provides an overview of assignment rules in ServiceNow Express and how to create them for tasking incidents. What are assignment rules and how do they work? Assignment rules allow you to automatically assign tasks to users and/or groups. Assignment rules automatically run when a record is either created or updated in a specific table and all the conditions are met. In this video, we focus on assignment rules configured for the incident table. For example, you could set record conditions that a rule applies only if an incident's category is hardware and the caller is in a certain location. Even if the record conditions are met, assignment rules are only applied if the task record is not already assigned to a user or group. If more than one assignment rule matches all conditions, only the rule with the lowest order value runs. We'll look at this concept in more detail later in the video. To see all assignment rules in your instance, navigate to System Configuration, Business Logic, Assignment Rules. To see only incident assignment rules, you can use the shortcut on the System Administration homepage. By default, the system has predefined incident assignment rules. Let's take a closer look. The Networking Assignment Rule assigns all incoming incidents in this category, Network, to the network group and the system administrator. The Database or Software Assignment Rule assigns all incoming incidents in either of these categories to the software group and the system administrator. The Service Desk Assignment Rule assigns all other incoming incidents which meet the condition active is true to the Service Desk group. So couldn't the Service Desk Assignment Rule also apply to an incoming incident in the Network, Database, or Software categories? Yes, but that's where order comes in. Rules are evaluated based on their order number, from the lowest to the highest. The first rule that matches the conditions gets executed, and the remaining ones are ignored. Notice that the Networking and Database or Software Assignment Rules both have an order number of 100, and the Service Desk Assignment Rule has an order number of 1,000. So the Networking and Database or Software Assignment Rules are evaluated before the Service Desk Assignment Rule. This means that the Service Desk Rule is only processed against new incidents that were not assigned by one of the other assignment rules. When you create your own assignment rules, a good practice is to set them up based on category or priority. You could assign all incidents in a particular category to a person or team who handles that category. For example, all incidents in the hardware category would be assigned to your IT group. As another example, you can assign high and critical priority incidents to key personnel to keep them apprised of the progress on resolving those incidents. Now let's create a new assignment rule on the incident table that will assign all critical priority incidents to the system administrator. We'll enter a descriptive name for the assignment rule. We can change the order number if needed. If you wanted this assignment rule to be evaluated before others in the system, for example, you could make the number smaller than 100. In this case, we want critical priority incidents to always go to the system administrator, regardless of category. So we'll change the number to 40. Now we specify the conditions in the Applies To tab. For our example, we only need one. Priority is critical. You can designate one user, a group, or both in the Assign To tab. In this case, we want to assign critical priority incidents to one user, our system administrator. After we submit the form to create the assignment rule, we can test it by adding a new critical priority incident. Note that the incident is assigned to system administrator automatically. For more information, please consult our product documentation, videos, or blogs, or ask a question in the ServiceNow Express forums.